Now that we're getting a little bit more comfortable with the process of animating, I thought it'd be a good time to start talking about staging. Staging is one of the principles of animation that really helps us direct our characters within inside the confines of a shot. Think of staging similar to what a director on a film would do, or a director would do to the actors on a traditional theater stage. It's the alignment of these characters and the set pieces themselves to produce this illusion of a three-dimensional universe. As animators, this is such an important concept for us because we're working in a two-dimensional medium that we need to describe, if you will, as a three-dimensional environment. And it's a little bit tricky. And there's some things in here inside the staging framework that we can do to very quickly remind our audience of depth. For me, staging is all about making relationships, one of which is the relationship to the scene, and then the relationship to each other, the characters within inside the scene itself. Actors are phenomenal at staging themselves, exploring how they can present themselves, their movement, their characters, their voice, their timbre of their speaking, in a way to create a relationship with the other actors inside the scene itself. Same goes for how we place all of our set pieces inside of our scene. It creates the illusion of depth, or maybe we want to, in a shot, make the illusion so that it feels constricted, so that it's flat. You know, this is all purpose built. As animators, we're striving to do the exact same thing. Now, we're going to be exploring staging in two different projects this week. The first one's going to be a simple bouncing ball animation, and in every sense, it's going to continue what we learned last week when it came to arcs and squash and stretch. But we're going to layer on this staging idea, by generating the illusion of a background, of middle ground, and a foreground. We're going to ask our ball to animate from the back of our environment all the way up here to the front where the audience is. It's a simple way for us to create this illusion of depth. The medium in which we're going to do this is scale. By changing the size of the sphere as it goes, as it animates inside of our scene, we create the illusion of depth, that it's small way out at the horizon line and much bigger as it reaches the foreground of our scene. So let's go in and start working on our animation to create the illusion of depth through the staging of our actors. I've just started a brand new little project file here. And before we get into it, I think I'm gonna do just a couple little housekeeping things. I like to start with a fresh palette. The first thing that I'm gonna do is jump over into my animation layers and just kind of remove the two animation layers that come with every project. And simply just create a new one. Name it scene, and I wanna place all of my scene elements in here. We're gonna create some additional animation layers as we go that'll help us organize all the strokes and create a whole series of intelligent layers that will aid in our animation process inside of the scene here in a minute. In addition, I also wanna go into my material library and just kind of remove some of the materials that I know I'm not gonna need. So specifically, I don't need square strokes, the red one. Dot stroke, we're gonna have it go away. We'll keep the solid fill here, and we'll use the solid stroke layer just to kind of very quickly throw down some lines. Now, the first thing that I want to do on this animation layer is to create a horizon line. As I mentioned, we're going to be animating our object going from the background to the foreground. I'm going to undo. That's a little too small for my taste. This way, you guys can see at home what we're working with here. Make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, there we go. I like that. That's a good place to begin. Nice little horizon line within the scene itself. I'm gonna go into my drawing tool real fast and start to doodle. I'm just gonna explore and experiment. I need to start wrapping my head around this problem, if you will. Exploring what it is that I'm trying to achieve. I know in concept, I'm trying to go in and have a ball start here and end way at over here. That's the big picture idea. Ideally, I want this to kind of jump like this, have some nice arcs, and eventually go from the background where it's small to the foreground where it's big. Now, how am I going to do this? How am I going to create this illusion of perspective? How am I going to create this an accurate sense that the ball is moving from the background all the way to the foreground? Because in doing so, we have to be very mindful of the size, scale, and proportion of the ball, but we also have to look at the timing of that animation itself. When things are way off in the distance, the timing is gonna be different versus when they're closer. Actually, when something's way off in the distance, our perceived understanding of its movement is gonna be a little bit slower. And then as it gets closer, it's gonna start moving fast, or our perception of its movement is gonna be much faster. So there's some ideas in here that I need to start exploring as I begin to prototype my animation. the first thing that we're going to take care of is the staging of this. Just figuring out the fundamental movement path of my little ball so that we're reproducing this illusion of depth. I'm going to go in and just kind of go back in time and clean up some of my animation or my drawings here and start using some real spheres. There we go. That's a good place to start. And what's this end pose going to be? Maybe something like this. It's going to be quite small and then go to be something quite big. To help just kind of visualize my animation, I'm going to create a custom material for my ball. As one might imagine, I'm going to call it ball. And I want it to have an outline. We'll keep it black. And then the fill color, oops, the fill color for this guy, we're going to make white. There we go. Let's go into edit mode real fast so we can assign this new material to both of these strokes simultaneously. I just held down the shift key while I grabbed both of those strokes. And then over here in my material properties area, I can click on the assign button. And there we go. Now we're starting to see that layering effect. These balls these objects in here are being filled with white, which is occluding that horizon line in the background. Just makes it a little bit easier for me to see what's going on. All right, I'm gonna grab this one. And let's experiment here with where I want this to begin. Yeah, maybe right about there. That sounds pretty good. And this is where it's gonna end. Now remember, at the beginning of our animation, our ball is way off in the distance, and then it's going to be bouncing to the foreground. Well, how do I figure out that motion path? Where is it going to be bouncing inside the frame itself? How can I ensure that the bounces that I create are consistent, right? I want it to be bouncing in a straight line. So I don't want it to be bouncing, you know, oops. I don't want it to be bouncing kind of all over the place. I want to try to make it as clean of an angle as I can. And the way we do that is by describing some movement paths with some lines inside of our scene itself. Now, I want to pay very close attention to the center point or my perceived center point of these balls. Now, if you're off a little bit, that's okay. This is not rocket science. We're not sending someone to the moon, okay? We're just trying to make some lines. And if you're off a little bit, that's cool too. It's still going to work. The first thing that I'm going to do is that I want to draw a line from the top of my sphere to the top of my small sphere. Same thing for the bottom. Bottom of the big sphere to the bottom of the small sphere. And now we can start to see how the boundaries in which this sphere is going to grow. We know pretty quickly that it's never going to be, the size of the sphere is never going to grow outside of that cone that we just created, right? You can actually start to see it in your imagination going from this size, whoop, to this size way over here. So we started to figure out the scale. Well, what about the placement of this object in the bounce itself? How is it going to move from the background to the foreground? Where is that middle pose? Because we're working in a scene that's staged to include depth, that middle pose is not where you think it's going to be. That middle pose, often people think, well, it's just going to be, you know, the in-between middle pose between the small sphere and the big sphere. It's going to be, oh, I don't know, right here in the center. Well, it's not actually. And here's a way for us to test it. Let me show you. We're going to go back to our line tool and we're going to use some perspective lines to help us figure out where the middle pose is in perspective. This illusion of depth is going to give our audience a tremendous connection to what it is that we're animating. But, you know, sometimes it's a little bit tricky to start figuring out how to draw it. Let me show you a great little trick. And this time we're figuring out the location of the ball in the middle of its movement path. This time, we're gonna go from the top of the sphere to the bottom of the small sphere, okay? And then we're gonna do the exact opposite. Once again, we're gonna go from the bottom of the sphere, of the big sphere, to the top, right about there, of the small sphere. And at the intersection of those two lines, so right here inside of the frame, that's going to be, that's the middle spot for our ball. That's that mid pose. Let's just duplicate that drawing. I'm gonna put it right there in the middle. Hit the S key to scale it up. And there it is. Pretty cool, huh? Now we can start to see that this is the first pose. This is the second pose. Well, what's that third pose right in here? What's that third jump gonna look like? Well, let's do the exact same thing with our intersecting lines one more time. Let's go back into draw mode. I have my line tool. And this time, we're not gonna have intersection lines going to this guy way over here, okay? We want those intersection lines beginning from that middle ball. Something like that. There we go. Same tops to bottoms. And then once again, we get a middle line. Cool, huh? Let's grab our sphere. Shift D to duplicate it. I'm going to put it kind of in the middle and scale it up just like we did last time. And as you can see now, we're getting a much stronger result here. We're starting to get a good sense of the spacing of the drawings to create this illusion that it's going from the background to the foreground. This is an excellent way to lay the foundation for the staging of our actors. I always like to think of the objects inside of the scene as little actors, right? And I get to direct where they're going to produce the illusion that I'm after. So the staging of our animation is super important because it creates depth. It creates drama. It creates that emotion within inside of the scene, all elements that our animations should be infused with, so our audience is really digging the animations that we create.